Welcome to this video on annotating sequences in SnapGene. SnapGene offers three basic types of sequence annotation: enzymes, features, and primers. By default, SnapGene displays restriction enzyme sites that appear once in your sequence and have a 6 or more base pair recognition site. Restriction enzymes that only cut once are marked in bold. And the hover option allows you to access more detail easily. SnapGene allows you to remove enzymes manually, either one at a time or all at once. To add individual enzyme sites, use the search field or filter by enzyme set. Keyboard shortcuts allow you to remove enzymes directly from the plasmid map. You may want to hide some or all items without removing them. There are several ways to do this. By using the keyboard shortcut via the hide button in the sidebar, or by selecting them via the enzyme tab. Here you can easily find and add enzymes and view different enzyme sets. You can also hide enzymes or remove them from your chosen enzymes. SnapGene comes preloaded with hundreds of features found on common cloning vectors and automatically adds relevant features to any new DNA sequence. The Detect Common Features option allows you to match, view, sort, and add features to your sequence. You can also create new features by highlighting the relevant area on the plasmid map or the sequence view and choosing Add Feature. As with enzymes, you can quickly toggle features on and off in both map and sequence view. To see a complete list of the features in your sequence, simply click the Features tab. Here, you can sort or search features, expand to show feature details in full, or hide and show features individually or in bulk. You can click the right button to expand, collapse, or sort all rows. You can create new primers via the sequence view. Click and drag to select a target primer binding site. SnapGene will automatically calculate the length and melting temperature of the matching primer. It's easy to convert your selection to a new primer via the primer menu window. Primers on opposing strands are clearly indicated in both sequence and map views. As with other annotations, you can toggle primers on and off from the sidebar. Or click on the Primers tab to view, sort, and search the complete list of primers in your sequence. There are options to show or hide primers, and the expanded display allows you to check the structure of your primer. SnapGene can also automatically design primers for specific cloning techniques via the Actions menu. And that's how to work with annotations in SnapGene. To learn more, visit snapgene.com.